Hello, my name is Marloes Mul and I'm an Associate Professor of Water Resources Management at IHC Delft Institute for Water Education. Today I'm going to talk about the WaPOR data and version history. The first version of the WaPOR data, the beta version, became available in 2017, starting with the continental scale, and over the following months the country level data and first high resolution areas were added. This beta version was evaluated and tested by the WaPOR team. Initial bugs were fixed and interception was added to the evapotranspiration. The first official version was then launched in August 2018. This version was evaluated in detail and improvements were suggested for version 2. This version now provides total biomass production, whereas the older versions provided above ground biomass production, which used a fixed above over total ratio of 0.65, which actually differs per vegetation and crop type. Now users can apply their own ratio of above over total biomass to calculate the above ground biomass data. Various other improvements were made based on parameterization. The final version of the WaPOR data was launched in 2023. An update was made in the input data to calculate the global WaPOR data. In addition, further parameterizations were made. More details regarding the different version of the WaPOR data can be found in the course material. The WaPOR database has three so-called levels, which relate to the spatial resolution and are provided for different geographical areas. For version 2, the level 1 data has a spatial resolution of 250 meters and covers the African continent and Near East area. The level 2 data has a spatial resolution of 100 meters and is available for specific countries and river basins. Finally, the high resolution data of 30 meter resolution is made available for specific areas, mostly focusing on agricultural lands. In the map, you can see the available locations of version 2 data. This version of the WaPOR data is available for the time period 2009 to 2023. The WaPOR database version 2 consists of various data products that support the monitoring of water use in agriculture. Most layers are available at each level, except for the climate layers in the form of precipitation and reference evapotranspiration, which are available only for level 1, but also at the coarser resolution due to the underlying resolution of the input data. The precipitation data has a spatial resolution of 5 kilometers and is derived from the CHIRPS dataset with some gap filling done. The reference ET data is created specifically for WaPOR and is available at 20 kilometer resolution. Both datasets are made available at daily, decadal, monthly and annual time steps. The water-related data layers are all created specifically for the WaPOR database and consist of separate layers for interception, evaporation and transpiration, as well as a combined layer of actual evapotranspiration and interception. All these layers are available at decadal, monthly and annual time steps. The land layers consist of net primary production, which is then converted to total biomass production. It also provides the land cover classification, which is derived from the Copernicus land cover map of 2015, with an annual update of the cropland into irrigated, rainfed and fallow based on a water deficit index. The level 3 data has a crop classification map developed by WaPOR. The phenology layer is derived from satellite-based vegetation index time series and provide the start and end of the cropping season. This information is available only for level 2 and 3. The water productivity layers consist of both net and gross water productivity layers, which is calculated by dividing the biomass production over transpiration or evapotranspiration, either at annual timescales for level 1 and seasonal timescales based on the phenology for level 2 and 3. Additional datasets are available that detail the quality of the NDVI and LST layers. A new version of WaPOR, version 3, was released in October 2023. This data is available in a dedicated hand-in-hand portal available through the presented link. This WaPOR version 3 now provides data for the entire globe at 300 meter resolution. The level 2 data of 100 meter resolution is available for the old WaPOR extent of Africa and MENA region. Level 3 areas will remain available for specific areas only. The temporal availability of the version 3 data is from 2018 to present. The WaPOR version 3 data contains two different climate data components, namely precipitation and reference evapotranspiration. The precipitation data is derived from the CHIRPS dataset with some gap filling done. and is available at 5 km resolution. The reference ET data of the WaPOR version 3 has a resolution of 30 km and is derived from GEOS 5 for the near real-time processing and Ag Era 5 for the final product. Other similar data products available within the WaPOR portal include precipitation and reference evaporation, derived from the Ag Era 5, which is located under the AquaMaps tab. Both data sets have a spatial resolution of 10 km. These components are available for different temporal resolutions, daily, decadal, monthly, and annual. The four water data components are the same as in version 2, include evaporation, transpiration, interception, and the sum of the three, actual evapotranspiration and interception. All data is available at decadal and annual time steps, whereas the actual evapotranspiration interception is also available at monthly time steps. For the land components, WaPOR version 3 provides decadal and monthly net primary production data and relative root zone soil moisture data, only available at decadal time steps. For selected level 3 areas, WaPOR will also provide decadal maps of crop classification. Global land cover classification is available in the hand-in-hand portal, both the Copernicus land cover classification of 2015, as well as the 2020 and 2021 ASA world cover maps are available under the hand-in-hand tab in the portal. Finally, the WaPOR version 3 data will contain composite data products, which include both annual maps of total biomass production, which is derived from the net primary production data, as well as net and gross biomass water production derived from the total biomass production over actual evapotranspiration interception or divided by the transpiration, the last one being the net biomass water productivity layer. Thank you for your attention.